My name is Ryan Hirschbiel, and I'll be defending on why the Anax Imperator is a better hunter than the Antlion, also known as the Glenis Crapturus. Since the question is who is a better predator, Imperator Dragonflies or Antlions, it is key to look at what prey they target and how they locate and catch said prey. Emperor Dragonflies eat a variety of insects ranging from flies, wasps, bees, and even an occasional butterfly, pretty much whatever they can get their hands on. While antlions, on the other hand, almost exclusively eat ants, which is why they're called antlions. This diversified range of prey shows that they can catch more different variety of species and proves why they're the better hunter. And the bugs that the emperor dragonfly catch is far more difficult because they can fly, and even insects such as butterflies are far bigger than just ants. And the crazy part about this is that they do this at a catch rate of over 95%, making them nature's most efficient hunters. So, emperor dragonflies are also the largest and quickest out of the species of dragonflies that live in Europe. They measure about 3 inches and can dart through the air at a startling 24 miles per hour. And they can also stop, start on a dime, fly forwards, backwards, up and down at very fast rates, and this makes them very skilled hunters because they fly from the air, and they also, their eyes are extremely intricate. They can see in a spherical view around the world, and so they fly above their prey and locate them, and then they swoop down on them at very fast speeds, and then they catch them with their spiked legs, which allows a better grip and hold on these animals. And so my argument revolves around their wide range of prey that they can catch, and also the difficulty of how their hunting methods compared to just setting a trap, and also how efficiently they do that.
Hello everyone, my name is Garrett Jones, and the insect that I will be defending as the better predator is the Glenis gratus, or the antlion. The Glenis gratus can be found in many regions throughout the United States, from Florida all the way to Wisconsin. Antlions live in a variety of different habitats, ranging from forest floors, hollowed out trees, and sand dunes. The larvae can live up to 2 years with proper conditions until they undergo metamorphosis and turn into something similar to a dragonfly. As an adult, the antlion is no longer as much of a skillful predator and will only live for around 4 more weeks. So I will focus on the larval stage of the antlion, which gives us the best look at what an efficient predator they are. The strategy of the antlion's hunting revolves around a trap that they set. The insect will burrow into the sand and start creating a circular groove while throwing up sand with its mandibles. It will continue to move deeper until it creates a sand pit with sides that drop unaware insects, mostly ants, right towards the antlion's dangerous mandibles. The antlion will lock onto the insect and start siphoning out the insides of the prey until it is an empty husk, and then spit it out of the pit. It is amazing that antlions can create these detailed traps and use miniature landslides to always outsmart their prey. Humans have also used pitfall traps dating back thousands of years, but these insects have perfected this strategy for much longer, performing skillful tasks with detail and precision. During the larval stage of life, the antlion can create hundreds of different traps and consume hundreds of insects. This shows how antlions are experts of surviving in competitive conditions. If their trap is destroyed by wind or rain or a predator, they will just move on to the next location. My argument for the antlion being the most effective predator revolves around the strategy that they use to create and use their traps with the utmost skill and precision. An example of another insect that uses traps to capture their prey is a spider, which is considered one of the most masterful hunters. And the fact that humans have adopted a similar method to hunting animals just shows how ingenious their pitfall trap is. While dragonflies may be masters of aerial hunting, but their methods involve expending large amounts of time and energy chasing their prey, which is just less efficient than waiting for your prey to come to you.
Antlions' hunting strategy is built around their prey coming to them. They burrow in these holes and set a pretty dangerous trap. And the ant is honestly a dead man walking as soon as it comes into the trap. But the question is, how often do they go into this trap, and what happens if the ants do not just walk up to them? That is why they are not as efficient at hunters, because the dragonfly can seek out their prey, much like the world's most apex predators do, such as grizzly bears and great white sharks and lions. They all locate and track their prey and then strike. Going on the offensive is much more of an apex way of hunting, And that is exactly what dragonflies do. It is far more difficult, and they do it at a very high percentage. So what happens if the prey doesn't go to the antlion's trap? They can't go seek out their prey and find it like a dragonfly does. So they are pretty much screwed at that point, because they could get up and move a hole, but what if the ants don't go there? They can't really seek out their prey like a dragonflies do, and that's why dragonflies have such a huge advantage in their hunting methods and why they're a better predator.
The emperor dragonfly's most useful skill is its flying abilities, which are second to almost none in the insect world. They have speed, maneuverability, and the sight required to be an amazingly effective predator, as they are better suited than the insects they hunt. But they also have to hunt and chase their prey, expending large amounts of energy. Similar to bees, their wings are moving so much that consumes large amounts of power, which they then need to eat more to make up for it. The antlion strategy, on the other hand, shows that this is more of a master hunter, as it doesn't need to constantly seek out its prey and use up precious energy. Rather, it chooses a location that it knows will involve the right amount of insect traffic so it has a steady supply of food. The antlion will not choose a place where ants or other insects it feeds on are not found, and if the antlion does experience a shortage of food, it can just move along to the next location and build a trap there. Also, I think that we are making insects look more scarce than they actually are. There are an estimated 100 trillion ants. This is a huge amount of ants for antlions to prey on, and positioning correctly will result in an abundance of food.
The key thing to look at in debating these two is how easily the insect can be eaten. Being a dangerous predator also means that you're not an easy prey. Dragonflies are extremely hard to catch. They can see pretty much everything. They're extremely quick, pretty small, and can fly through the air and avoid the things that hunt them, such as lizards and even sometimes bees and things like that, but they can fly so much quicker. Antlions, on the other hand, are pretty much trapped in their holes. I know the holes give some camouflage and some protection, but what happens if a larger animal that eat them, such as coyotes and lizards, dig up the hole? Then they're pretty much dead. Like, they cannot escape, they cannot really fly as well, and so they're a pretty easy target. And this is just another reason why dragonflies are the more efficient predator, because they're not always constantly worried about being eaten and are very difficult to catch.
Antlions are not invincible and are part of the food chain just like anything else. Known predators of antlions are hawks, cranes, frogs, and ground squirrels. But it is inconvenient for these animals to dig up their holes for such a small amount of food so often that it will go unnoticed by many other predators. Antlions are also equipped with camouflage, allowing them to often blend in with their sand or dirt environment if their trap is compromised, or if they are moving to the next location. An argument could be made that antlions are at a disadvantage hidden in their holes, as they are trapped if they are attacked. But the main point is that they are hidden from sight, unaware to almost everyone. I didn't even know they existed until before my research, so that kind of sounds like they're doing their job right. Dragonflies, on the other hand, are constantly moving around hunting for their prey, but in this they are visible to many of the predators who eat them. The dragonfly's hunting strategy of constant movement leads to more opportunity for their predators to see them and attempt to eat them. Then dragonflies will use their speed and superior sight to try to evade the predators, but it will not always work out. Antlions are able to remain hidden using their predator strategy, while dragonflies catch the sight of their predators and the hunter becomes the hunted.
I truly believe that emperor dragonflies are a much more dangerous predator than the antlion. There are many reasons behind this conclusion, but it can be summed up in a couple facts. Number one being their ability to fly and the speed and quickness that they can do it. Number two, their great eyesight, which is unrivaled by any other insect. Their wide array of prey that they seek after, and how difficult it is for them to be caught. Like I said earlier, they can fly in any direction, stop on a dime, and accelerate with lightning speed. They have the best eyesight in the animal kingdom compared to their body. They hunt large insects such as butterflies and wasps, and they cannot be crept up on by other animals because of their extreme eyesight. So in conclusion, emperor dragonflies are a far better predator than antlions.
In conclusion, I believe that the research shows that the Glenurus gratus, or antlion, is a better predator than the Anax imperator, or the emperor dragonfly. The antlion employs a well-thought-out and strategic method of creating a dangerous trap and waiting for the prey to come to it. Then it will lock onto the ant and siphon out its insides for food and go back into hiding. This allows the antlion to conserve energy as the prey comes to it and remains hidden from other predators in the protection of its hole. The emperor dragonflies incorporate skillful flying and vision to catch their prey, and while this is very effective, it is not the best way. Their constant movement requires the large amounts of energy to be spent, which they then need to eat more to sustain. Then, in the perpetual hunting, they catch the attention of many predators, increasing the opportunity for them to be eaten. Therefore, in my opinion, the pitfall strategy that the antlion employs leads it to being a better predator than the emperor dragonfly.